Welcome to your source for research, innovation, news, insights, and commentary. This is Research Business Daily Report, where we're sponsored today and this week by Nuance, offering multi-language verbatim coding services to help companies quantify the meaning of open-ended answers. Nuance, a decision analyst company. Disruptive technology is a dream situation, even in research. I know a lot of companies out there are on the constant lookout for something that will totally change the market. But is it really the be-all, end-all? There's reason to wonder after reviewing why disruptive innovation can help market leaders. You heard that correctly. In a study from the Wharton School to be published in a journal called Management Science, the upshot is that disruptive innovation actually helps market leaders. It's in a paper authored by Wharton professor David Hsu, MIT professor Matthew Marks, and University of Toronto professor Joshua Gans. And it concludes that startups introducing disruptive technology with long-term potential are more likely to end up licensing to incumbents or agreeing to be acquired than becoming a vaunted rival of the established dominant players in the market. The piece makes the salient point that even for disruptive innovation startups, competing in the marketplace is secondary to proving the worth of the innovation. Once an innovation proves itself, startups tend to form alliances or merge with market leaders. This is referred to in the paper as cooperative commercialization strategy. The result, in the end, is preservation of the status quo, not exactly what we would have all thought from disruptive technology. It's an extraordinary, surprising end result, I thought. So give this summary again. It's called Why Disruptive Innovation Can Help Market Leaders a read. It's well worth your time. Next, while driver monitoring, which Progressive Insurance and Allstate are undertaking, is quite different from the research that we tend to think about day to day, the collected data is potentially meaningful and perhaps, obviously, can be life-saving. Progressive is working on a smartphone app that says it will monitor how its customers are driving. Allstate is already testing its DriveWise app, doing much the same thing. It's in Montana, Nebraska, and New Hampshire, and it's getting feedback on driving behavior. All of this information, by the way, was provided to us by Forbes.com's Parmi Olson. Progressive's developing app is supposed to note and transmit when a driver slams on his brakes or speeds. The app could also offer GPS data. Of course, there's already an app doing much of this, and surprise, surprise, it's Google that has it. It bought the Waze app from an Israeli firm about a year ago, and it collects user speed and driving history 30 days at a time. Google is even sharing portions of that data with some local authorities. That's your Research Business Daily Report, sponsored by Nuance, offering multi-language verbatim coding services to help companies quantify the meaning of open-ended answers. Nuance, a decision analyst company, wants to help you find out more about Nuance and to make it easy. So they and we have created a link. It is www.nuancecoding.com. Take a look and you'll see why it's well worth consideration. Have a great research day, and we'll see you right back here tomorrow.